Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. In this video, I will discuss about Patau syndrome. Patau syndrome was first reported by the geneticist Dr. Klaus Patau in 1960. Dr. Patau and his colleague published a paper describing the chromosomal abnormality in a group of children with a combination of severe physical and developmental abnormality. The syndrome was named after Dr. Patau in recognition of his groundbreaking work in identifying the condition. Patau syndrome, also known as trisomy 13, is a rare and severe genetic disorder caused by the presence of an extra copy of chromosome 13 in a person's cell. Instead of the usual two copies of chromosome 13, individuals with Patau syndrome have three copies, leading to a various developmental and physical challenges. Patau syndrome prevalence is estimated to be about 1 in 10,000 to 16,000 live births. However, the incidence may be higher during early pregnancy, but not all affected pregnancies result in live births. A significant number of pregnancies with trisomy 13 result in miscarriage or stillbirth. Many fetuses with Patau syndrome do not survive to birth. As with many chromosomal disorders, the risk of having a baby with Patau syndrome increases with maternal age. Patau syndrome affects many parts of the body and typically associated with severe intellectual disability and a shortened life expectancy. Some common characteristics include developmental delays, cleft lip and or cleft palate, microcephaly, that is a small head, eye defects including a small eye, or that is microphthalmia, or absence of eye, that is anophthalmia, polydactyly, heart defect, brain malformations like holoprosencephaly, etc. Patau syndrome is caused by a chromosomal abnormality called trisomy 13, where a person has an extra chromosome 13 in all or most of their cells. This extra genetic material disrupts normal development. The condition can occur sporadically, usually as a result of a random error during the formation of egg or sperm. In some cases, a parent may carry a balanced translocation, which increases the risk of having a child with trisomy 13. Most affected infants have a very short life expectancy. Around 80 to 90% of infants with Patau syndrome die within the first year of life, often due to complications from heart defect, infection, or brain malformations. However, some individuals survive longer depending on the severity of the abnormalities and the availability of medical care. Syndrome can be diagnosed through prenatal tests such as chorionic villus symplasia, that is CVS, or amniocentesis, which analyze the chromosomes of the fetus. After birth, diagnosis is typically confirmed through chromosomal analysis, that is karyotype. There is no cure for Patau syndrome, and treatment focuses primarily on providing supportive care, managing medical complications, and improving the child's quality of life. This may involve surgical corrections, therapy for developmental delays, and palliative care for those with severe cases. As the condition often leads to early death, the approach to care is tailored to the individual's child's needs and family preferences. This is all about Patau syndrome. Thanks for watching my video. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel for more health insights. Share this video with your friends and family to spread awareness. If you have any questions or queries, please drop a comment in comment box. And don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of your health. Thank you. Thank you very much.